Yes, dentists prescribe approximately 10% of all antibiotics in the United States and are the top specialty prescriber of antibiotics. Dentists are also the top prescriber of clindamycin. And of course, clindamycin historically has been associated with the highest risk of C. difficile infection. So we undertook this study to first assess the appropriateness of antibiotic prophylaxis prior to dental procedures, and then look at the potential serious adverse drug events after a patient took a dose of antibiotics prior to their dental visit.
Yeah, so when we looked at just the cohort of patients who had unnecessary antibiotic prophylaxis prior to their dental visits, we saw that about 4% of patients actually experienced a serious adverse event. So these are things like anaphylaxis, Clostridium difficile infection, new allergies, or emergency department visits. And so a lot of times this antibiotic prophylaxis is just a single dose of amoxicillin. And we really wanted to see, is this single dose associated with adverse harm? And we saw it is.
I think there's a perception that just taking a short course of antibiotics or just one dose does not cause any harm to the patient. And we saw that, in fact, it does cause harm.
So we're implementing antibiotic stewardship at UIC and the College of Dentistry. And so we've implemented an antibiotic stewardship program consistent with the CDC core elements of outpatient antibiotic stewardship. We've already shown a 70% decrease in the use of antibiotics for the treatment of oral infections in our urgent care dental clinic. And so there's a lot of other things we want to look at, especially allergies in our patients undergoing dental procedures, because a lot of times, as Katie mentioned, clindamycin is a common antibiotic used in dentistry and associated with a lot of adverse effects. And so we're trying to decrease clindamycin use. So that's one area.
And clindamycin is the second line agent currently recommended if the patient's allergic to penicillin. So thus the dentist does not prescribe amoxicillin, they'll prescribe clindamycin. I would also like to say that at the stewardship program at the University of Illinois at Chicago, we did implement the CDC core elements of outpatient antibiotic stewardship, and dentists and dental clinics are included as part of the target audience of those of that guidance. And this is really important to implement stewardship because in our previous study, we found that 80% of all antibiotics prescribed for infection prophylaxis prior to dental visits were unnecessary.
I mean, I think this is these harms that we're seeing in these patients receiving unnecessary dental prophylaxis really highlights the need for dentists, physicians, surgeons, and patients to start a conversation and really question. Maybe the patients could question, do I still need to be taking antibiotic prophylaxis? Because the treatment guidelines have changed over time and the practice hasn't changed.
But we also know that our findings are a conservative estimate of adverse drug events, because we only have events that a patient would seek care for, such as an allergic reaction where they would go to the emergency department or anaphylaxis. We also know that these events tend to be undercoded. And finally, patients frequently have nausea, vomiting, diarrhea from an antibiotic where they don't seek care. So we know this is a very conservative estimate of the true incidence of adverse drug events, even after a short course of antibiotics used for infection prophylaxis prior to dental visits.